Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of UBS after the Swiss banking giant resoundingly beat expectations for underlying profit. UBS shares surged over 3.5% in midday trading. Also in focus, shares of Britain's Metro Bank after the lender said deposit outflow rates had normalized since an October scare over its balance sheet. Investors, though, are unconvinced as shares of Metro Bank tumbled over 4%. We're also keeping a close watch of Spanish telecom giant Telefónica after it proposed a takeover bid for the remaining stake in Telefónica Deutschland Holding or Telefónica Deutschland Holding. Shares of Telefónica are down by 1% in pre-market trading. Asian markets closed Tuesday in a sea of red as investors parsed through trade data from China and a rate hike from the Australian Central Bank. Leading losses in the region is South Korea's KOSPI index, which tumbled more than 2%. This cancels out Monday's gains, where the Korean index posted its best session since March 2020. Hong Kong's Hang Seng index and Japan's Nikkei 225 also down by more than 1% today. Australia's ASX 200 is also down after the Reserve Bank of Australia raised its key policy rates by 25 basis points. Now, here at home, Philippine shares were spared from the bloodbath, managing to close higher by 0.9%. Sun Life Investment Management's Mike Enriquez, however, notes trading remains muted with very shallow trading activity.
We are all positioned, in fact. We're waiting for some help from foreign. Most of the investors continue to favor risk-free assets. They're mostly just placed in back time deposits, given the fact that time deposits offer 5-6%. Even a 10-year government bond rate has reached 7%. Until we see a reversal of interest rates, then that would be a more compelling reason for investors, at least domestic investors, I'm sorry, flocking back to the domestic equity. For investors, definitely it's something that we should take advantage of, especially when these trigger points, these turning points on inflation, these look at the movement of inflation, the movement of interest rates, the movement of the dollar peso rate. These are the things that will determine if the market will start to reverse.
Several local firms posting their nine-month earnings reports, starting with telco giant PLDT, which posted a 12% dip in its third quarter bottom line, bringing its nine-month profits just 1% up to nearly 28 billion pesos. Now, this is amid what the telco described as persistent macroeconomic challenges brought by inflation, high rates, and slowing economic growth. However, its consolidated services revenues grew to a record 142.3 billion pesos, with data and broadband contributing 82% to this. Meanwhile, Bloomberry more than doubles its nine-month profit after reporting a 20% growth in its third quarter bottom line. The Solaire operator says performance of its mass-oriented gaming segments, hotel and retail businesses offset its lower total gross gaming revenue. As for Ramon Ang's Petron, its nine-month bottom line rose to 9.5 billion pesos despite a slight dip in revenues due to price corrections from last year. The oil giant says its strong volumes helped offset a price correction and allow the company to absorb the over 50% rise in financing costs. Still in the earnings stream, Integrated Microelectronics posts a $1.6 million loss in the third quarter. This includes losses from SCI Limited as IMI worked to close a divestment transaction with R Capital. Its revenues also dropped slightly at $341 million in the third quarter due to a general slowdown and tightening working capital in the electronics industry. And finally, Globe Telecom signs long-term facilities with BPI, China Bank, and Robinsons Bank for 3, 5, and 4 billion peso loans, respectively. The loans will fund the telco giant's CAPEX and refinance debt.